Hi. Yeah, that's it. So, thank you, Ryan, for having me come out, and thank you, everybody, for coming here, and I, too, am excited to be reading with my co-readers, and the folks who already read. I don't know if you can hear me. This is not... There you go. Can you hear me? Is this working? Awesome. Okay, so... Damn. All right, so there's a lot of people talking about God, I guess, tonight, so it is unfortunate that that is all I talk about. So I'm going to read... I'm going to read a poem from a book I'm writing, which is, I guess it's my fifth book. And I'm going to read a poem from my fourth book, which I just finished up. And they are both about God. I did not grow up in the church, but I wanted to and still want to be a priest. So there you go. And for a long time, I kind of wrote poems one way, and now I'm trying to write poems another way. I don't know if they're any good, but... this first one has a kind of long title. It's called, "When I Was a Kid, I Used to Play in the Foothills of the Mountains with My Friend. We found a cave network that had been in use and abandoned. Inside we found the moon. It was as big as a house, but light and weight. We would roll it around in a big part of the cave, but could not get it out of the cave network. Don't know how it got in there." That was a comment on a YouTube video. The person was completely serious. So, the moon, it was a house as big as a house. We found a network of caves, a series of holes in the hills and the mountains' feet. Our foot seems wrong to say that something so big only has one foot, but more wrong to say a mountain has legs. I mean, specifically more than one. One foot in many hills. No legs you ever been in. A room so dark you honestly couldn't see your hand in front of your face. My friend and me, we hadn't gone too deep anyway. It wasn't our first time anyway in this particular cave, but it felt too deep. And at the end of it, we found it didn't end. And once we got past the first cave, I wouldn't have been scared to follow the caves until there weren't more caves to follow. But about the third cave deep, we found the moon. You ever been alone, deep in a cave, no guide? A cave is what I'll tell you. It's what happens when a mountain realizes it was made by God. It's basically permanent, uncomfortable self-talk. And three caves deep, we found the moon. You won't believe me, but I remember. The cave was bright and lit, I'll tell you, by the earth itself. And what I'll tell you about light is it rises from the dirt if the dirt wants you to see. The moon was a giant beach ball with no seams, a shadow passing over it. No matter where we rolled it, but we couldn't roll it out. It looked, it felt like a beach ball, glossy smooth. But the moon didn't give. We couldn't squeeze it through the entrance of the cave. Must have been cameras hidden somewhere. Must have been a projector hidden somewhere. But all we ever saw were wires connected to nothing, a void. What always worried me was if I couldn't picture heaven, I wouldn't get to heaven. And this one is the one that was making me have trouble breathing in advance because it is 30 pages long and it is hard to read. And I'm already in pain thinking about it. And it's called...